boat is here and we're on our way to game.
It can look easy, like I made it overnight. I'll make it look easy.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Astrid, and on today's video, oh my god, Farida.
Let it go, let it go.
While she does her thing, today we are going to be doing, according to the title, we're going to be doing, that's spooky, as you know. So today we're going to be doing a dorm recipe kind of video for you guys, you know, things you can cook with a microwave in the dormitory. So we're going shopping now, we're going to game. First of all, we have to go and carry this human being to our house because
I never bath.
She never bath. So yeah, we're taking her back to our house, and then from our house we're going to go to game and then get some things we need for the recipes. So sorry, the recipes we need. God, English. Anyways, I'm going to see you guys when we're at Farida's place and she's ready for us to leave. I don't know you guys, like, next burning down. I don't want to go to any other place to shop, but I have no choice because next burnt down. So we have to go to game because game is cute and I like cute places. I like the fact that you have like pink trolleys to push around. So anyways, I'll see you guys later. So guys, this idiot has taken her, and she's eating bread. Ew. But anyways, our boat is here and we're on our way to game. Here's Vicky. Cute as hell, cute as hell, cute. Yeah, we're going to game, so see you whenever. Oh my gosh, the bread for me, like, you.
I'm hungry, man, I'm hungry.
Moments later.
So guys, we ended up coming to ShopRite because game has nothing. They don't have no game. Game doesn't have game.
Game has zero game.
They have zero game.
Zero.
So we're at ShopRite now trying to get the stuff.
10,000
for. Oh my god.
Doesn't even look nice.
Okay guys, so we're done shopping. Apparently we could not get everything at game, so we had to go to shop. Game had no game basically, so we had to go to shop right to get some more, a lot of this stuff. Sorry,
the whole of
Jabi Lake did not have flour. Like, bro, can you imagine? But yeah, we're outside in front of the lake. Wait, let me show you guys. Yeah, we're outside. That's the lake over there. That's Vicky over there. That's Vicky over there.
Hi!
That's Farida over there. Yeah, we all look tired and hungry because that's what we are. And yeah, we just can't wait for our home.
Arriving in 5 minutes.
I'm not going to be making the video today because I am tired. I mean, today's what? Yeah, so today's Tuesday and I'll be filming like the recipes tomorrow, which is Wednesday. I know I said on my channel that I'm going to be posting every Wednesday, but like things are gonna change. I think I'll be posting every Monday instead. been like 3 days since the last time I filmed the other clips, basically. So it's this Friday. Ooh, it's actually been like 2 days since the last time. But anyways, today is Friday and the time is
11:21.
Time is 11:21 and it's morning, so we're going to be making breakfast today. I'm going to be teaching you guys how to make oats with a microwave, because I know some of you do not know how to cook, and you come to school and be stuck and be buying food. But in order for you to save money, I'm going to be teaching you how to make, and it's even going to be healthy and delicious. So yeah, let's get into it. So for this recipe, you need a bowl and some white oats. I usually put about 6 spoons of oats into the bowl. That's the measurement we're going to be using. And then afterwards, you're going to put in some hot water. I already pre-boiled this off camera. So yeah. So after that, you give it a quick mix until the oats dissolve in the water, and then you put it in the microwave for about, say, 4 to 6 minutes, and then yeah, you come back to check it later. This is the texture you're going to get afterwards. It's a bit like chunky, but not to worry, we're going to be adding some almond milk inside. The almond milk I use is unsweetened. So yeah, after that you give it a stir until it's a bit creamy. So that's what you're going to be doing. Afterwards, you add in some natural honey. I use tropical sun honey. You add about a tablespoon of it into your oats and you mix. I don't use sugar because I'm not so much of a fan of sugar. For garnishing, I'm going to be adding some coconut flakes and some dates. You can add whatever you like fruits, like strawberries or grapes or whatever you wish to add. And that is the final look. Tasted absolutely delicious. It is a must try. For this next dish, you're going to be needing a microwave safe plate. You can find these in Sahad stores or any supermarkets or even in the marketplace. And then you're also going to need some spices like your black pepper, your red chili flakes, your curry powder, your onion powder, some macaroni and some bouillons and some vegetables of your choice. So what you're going to do is pour in the macaroni in the microwave safe plate and add some water until it covers the macaroni. Afterwards, you're going to add about 3 tablespoons of vegetable oil or olive oil, whatever oils you like to use. And then you're going to cover it up and put that in the microwave for about, say, 9 minutes. You bring that out and check the texture to see if it's kind of springy, and if it is, then that's when you know you should add your spices. Here you can add your proteins or whatever you like to garnish it with, basically things like sausages, sardines, eggs, whatever you like, you can add it at this point. I tried adding the bouillon cubes in there, but it was too hard for me to crush them, so I just dumped them in there. And I gave it a quick mix afterwards. Like, it's going to dissolve when you put it in the microwave, so you have no cause to worry. I also like to add about a tablespoon and a half of this tomato and pepper mix and just add some flavor to the macaroni. Then I gave it a quick mix, and then I added a bit of chili flakes because I like my food spicy. Then I put the lid back on, put it back in the microwave for like close to 3 minutes, and brought it back out, gave it another mix, and then I put it back in the microwave for some time, and boom, that's your macaroni for you. For this next recipe, you're going to need about 3 tablespoons of all-purpose flour because we're going to be making a mug brownie. You also need 2 tablespoons of granulated sugar, some cocoa powder, you can get this at the supermarket, some baking powder, about 1/4 spoon of that, and a pinch of salt.
Afterwards, you're going to mix in your dry ingredients. For the wet ingredients, you're going to add a teaspoon of vanilla essence, some melted margarine, and 3 tablespoons of milk. Any milk of your choice will do. To top it all off, we're going to be adding some milk chocolate bars. I don't have any chocolate chips, so I just pieces it into like small bites into the cup and then mix that in. And then I added like just one big chunk on the top of it and put that in the microwave for about 9 minutes. And this is what I came out with. Once the brownie is out, you let it cool for some time and then you add some whipped cream on top. Have it, absolutely beautiful. You can add some toppings if you like coconut flakes, bananas, whatever it is you like. So yeah, that's it.
Okay guys, we have come to the end of this video. So to end this video, Vicky is going to be doing the honors of tasting what the cake, the mug cake, tastes like.
It actually looks so delicious. Like, guys,
can you see this?
Look at this.
Oh my gosh. So anyways,
drum roll please.
Actually, dry out.
I'll not take this and just. I'll show you guys. Let me just. Oh, I'm over here.
But, anyways, yeah, thank you guys for watching.
Oh my god.
If you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up. And please subscribe. I love you guys so much.
And she I'm going to see. Yeah. And this cake. Oh my god.
I'm going to see you guys in my next video. So, bye. I want to go and fight for my cake.